We recently completed another successful roundtable event with fixed income once again coming under the spotlight, given the unprecedented returns that we're seeing from fixed income assets. In the first part of the presentation, our strategist, Bullen Budger, highlighted the unique fixed income environment that we find ourselves in. A lot of the moves being non-consensus, some of them being contrarian, and the surprising, you know, continued good performance from fixed income asset classes makes this a very difficult environment in which to invest. As a fixed income portfolio manager, I need to take that environment that Bullen has highlighted and figure out the perpetual challenge for investors of how to create real returns within fixed income. Now, there's a big theme that has done the rounds since the global financial crisis as to what level of real returns are sustainable and are achievable within the domestic fixed income market. And should we be shifting our sights and moving our targets from what we're used to in a previous structure or environment where kind of inflation plus 3% was always a given in a fixed income portfolio or an income type portfolio. So we looked at both of our flagship income funds, the Momentum Diversified Yield Fund and the Momentum Income Plus Fund. Both attempt to achieve CPI plus 3 over the medium to longer term in the domestic fixed income market, but they get there in different ways. The Diversified Yield Fund is our flexible asset allocation fund, using all the fixed income asset classes to generate active return above inflation. And the Income Plus Fund is our specialist high yield credit fund, using simply credit and yield in order to try and achieve its return. The Diversified Yield Fund has come up just shy of CPI plus 3 over a 10-year inception period, while the Income Plus Fund has got to CPI plus 3 comfortably over its slightly shorter inception period. That fund was launched in 2005. So going forward, both of those funds we look at relative to CPI, and we are cautiously optimistic that CPI plus 3 still remains a feasible target within domestic fixed income, notwithstanding all the warnings about financial repression and that return on asset classes will be lower and that the ability to generate active return will be lower in markets. We still think that over the medium term, in an actively managed fund where the portfolio manager makes smart decisions, that both of these portfolios are likely to get to CPI plus 3, and you don't need to venture out into the equity world and introduce a low weighting to equities into a fund in order to get to CPI plus 3. Introducing a slug of equity into income funds has its challenges anyway. We have an equity market that is arguably more overvalued than what domestic fixed income markets are at this stage, and it changes the volatility and risk metrics of the portfolio. So, you know, that's up to specific investors, but we've highlighted our two flagship income funds, which we think will continue to perform well in this environment, and we do think we'll make CPI plus 3 as an investment target over the medium term. It just may be with a little bit of volatility, and markets should continue to be unprecedented, as Bullen has highlighted, but at the same time, inflation is exhibiting signs of coming lower, which makes beating it by 3% slightly easier. So we look forward to next year, and we look forward to continued challenge in fixed income markets, but we trust that positive real returns for fixed income investors will be a theme that we can look forward to next year. So we end off this year thanking you for your continued support and look forward to the ride through unprecedented markets in 2015. Thank you.